So not as popular as the midsize luxury or compact luxury crossover segments, this relatively new segment, the small luxury compact, is nonetheless growing in numbers. While new for 2019, Lexus has entered the picture with the UX, the 200 and the 250H. This is the Lexus 200. It's an entry-level model. This is the least expensive Lexus you can get. But with the UX 200, all you get is a 2-liter, normally aspirated 4-cylinder engine. It puts out 169 horsepower, a significant disadvantage in comparison to the competition. The other thing is that the UX 200 is front-wheel drive only. You cannot get this with all-wheel drive. If you want all-wheel drive, you have to pony up for the 250H. Doesn't make a whole lot of sense to me. Even tipping the scales at a very trim 1500 kilograms, one of the UX 200's strengths will not be scintillating acceleration. Switching from either eco or normal to sport mode does give the impression of a little more urge. Now, in its favor, at least the engine is decently quiet under normal operation, though, like most small 4-cylinders, turbocharged or not, it takes on a coarser edge at higher revs when passing power is called for. At least its handling dynamics are up to snuff. It does very well in the corners, thanks to active cornering assist, and it helps Lexus trace the driver's desired line through a turn by applying some brake control on the inside wheels. This mitigates understeer. There's a solid weight from the electric power steering as well, and its ride is quite comfortable as well. Maybe not RX350 comfy, but more than acceptable considering the UX's shorter wheelbase. On the inside, the trackpad is somewhat frustrating to use, as are the radio controls, which for some strange reason are hidden in the center console. It's a good vehicle. Is it competitive with the other European brands? Not really. Is it priced better? Yes. You decide whether you actually like this vehicle, but to me, it's basically a high-riding hatchback. The fact that it doesn't have all-wheel drive is the biggest detriment, I think, to the Canadian market. For Driving.ca, I'm Brian Harper.